of Matthew, chapter number 9, verse number 14 to verse number 17, and I read, then John's disciples came to Jesus and asked, why do we and the Pharisees fast often, but your disciples don't fast? Jesus said to them, the wedding guests cannot mourn while the bridegroom is with them, can they? But the days are coming when the bridegroom will be taken from them, and then they will fast. No one puts a patch of unshrunk cloth on an old garment, for the patch pulls away from the garment, and the tear is made worse. Nor do they put new wine into old wineskins, or else the wineskins break. The wine is spilled, and the wineskins are ruined. But they put new wine into new wineskins, and both are preserved. Now, the Bible says, Jesus, he was with his disciples. Then the disciples of John the Baptist came to him. Now, akamuuliza, excuse me, sir, why do we and the Pharisees often fast and your disciples do not fast? The Bible says, Jesus said to them, Jesus did not answer them. Jesus said to them, most of the times, Jesus was asked a question, he never answered. He said to them. Now, the Bible says that Jesus said to them, how can people mourn when the bridegroom is around? Now, the disciples of John the Baptist were questioning the uniqueness in the disciples of Jesus. Why? Because they were used to a religious way of doing things. We are supposed to fast. Why aren't your disciples fasting, yet we are fasting? Why are they different? Why are they not doing what we are used to doing? Why are they not doing what we are doing? Why are they not doing what they are supposed to be doing? It was a religious mind. Now the difference with the disciples of Jesus is what made the disciples of John the Baptist question Jesus. The moment you become different, people must question your integrity. We are in 2014. One of the ways you are going to make it in this year is when you do not allow yourself to be like other people. When you refuse to come to the standards of other people for you to please them, by the end of the day, you will get yourself where you are. But if you want to get to a higher level, it is time you became different from other people. Refuse to compromise and make a decision and say, I will be who God called me to be. The moment you want to be like other people, it means you are ready to compromise your standard. The disciples of John the Baptist were actually questioning why the disciples of Jesus were not doing what they were doing. Because according to them, they were both disciples. Then they had to do what we are doing. But because they were disciples of Jesus, they had to be different. They had to be different. My friend, for you to make it in this year, you must decide to be different from everyone else. After all, people will question your uniqueness, but they cannot remove it from you. It is you who is going to become who God called you to become. Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, be different. The moment you want to be what other people expect you to be, you stop becoming what God wants you to be. Nirudie, the moment you want to become who other people expect you to become, you stop becoming who God wants you to become. I am through with pleasing men and women
so that they may be excited about me. I prefer now, in 2014, we are going to please God and let Him make us who we are supposed to be. The uniqueness in the disciples of Jesus is what made them different, and it is what made the disciples of John the Baptist question their integrity. Now, let us stop coming to church every Sunday. Let us stop coming to church every Sunday, listening to a new word and going back and doing the same things, then coming back to God and asking God, God, why haven't you done it for me? And yet you spoke it in your word. He spoke a new word. He expected you to go and do something new. Jesus continues and responds. And I want to be, how can people mourn when the bridegroom is around? When the bridegroom is around, people are supposed to be celebrating. But when the bridegroom leaves, they will fast. And that time is coming. Then the Bible says, Jesus continues and says, how can you put a new cloth into an old garment? Why? Because the new cloth will pull the old garment, and the old garment will tear even the more. Listen to me. If you want to get to a new realm, prepare yourself in a new way. You cannot have an old mindset in a new year. Everybody's excited. Happy New Year! Happy New Year! This is my year! You cannot enter into a new year with an old mindset. You will end up in the same place you were last year. You need a new mindset in the new year for you to make it in the new year. Change the way you think. Change the way you perceive things. Change the way you look at things. You want to make it in this year? Change your mindset. Last year, you are about to give up. This year, do not allow yourself to have any room for you to give up. Jesus continues and says, you cannot take new wine and pour it into old wineskin, because the old wineskin will burst, and the new wine and the old wineskin will be destroyed. But what do? You take the new wine and put it into new wineskin, and both the wine and the wineskins shall be preserved. It is time for you to make your mind fresh so that you can accommodate the big and new ideas God has for you in 2014. You cannot come into 2014 with a 2013 mindset. You can't. You will fail and fail and fail. You have been losing opportunities and opportunities. Maximize every opportunity that is laid before you, and now you can say, I am in 2014. I am not saying change what you have been doing. I am saying change what you have been doing. What do I mean? I do not mean stop becoming a businessman and become a driver. No, I am telling you, stop becoming the normal businessman and become a better businessman. You are doing the same thing in the same way, and you expect results. It is time for you to do the same thing, but in a different way, and get the results you desire.